Shalom, Yashrallah. Peace is all. First and foremost, as always, we want to give all praises and honor and glorification due to
Yahweh, Bashem, Yahushua, Bashem, Kakadash.
Double honor to our elders, Apostle, Great Nelson, James, Holwa, and our peace and blessings to the hopefully like Akiam out there pushing this gospel, this doctrine of Yahweh, Bashem, Yahushua, in righteousness, in the sincerity, and in truth, and also Shalom. Wabarakatham, peace and blessings to the brethren and the few sisters that may be tuning and listening, learning, studying the vibration of Yahweh, Bahashem Yahushua, Bahashem Kakadash. Yahweh, that's the Hebrew name of whom the world is going to call God, God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Yahweh means He is, He to be, He exists, the being that existed before time, also known as the Shadow of Days. And Yahusha Hamashiach, that's the Hebrew name of His beloved Son, whom the world is going to call Jesus Christ. Yahusha means He who saved, He who delivered, the Savior of the elect of the nation Israel, which also for blacks, Hispanics, Native Americans, West Indians, and Haitians. And according to the Bible, God's chosen people, Bahashem, Baha, which means in the Shem name, we call Spirit Kadash, surely in the name of the Holy Spirit, which allow us to be able to understand the scriptures. This is an appeal to Hebrew, the ancient Hebrew, the Lashon Kadash, the Holy Tongue, the language that Yahweh spoke to Saul on his way to Damascus, the language of the heavens. And once again, to all Yahweh Hashem Messiah for allowing us to be able to understand this wonderful gospel. I'm Banawa
Tazawa.
We to Akiam here from the GMS Boston Cape, linking up to the short lesson and our Lord willing, satisfying. And the title of the article speaks for itself, man. Now Esau is showing off his hatred that he has for his so-called black Hispanics and Native Americans. Our people fail to realize that they have enemies. Mm. They think that the so-called white man is their friend. That's the mistake that they're making. No, they think that Esau is their friend, man. These devils, they're about to show their true hatred that they have for you so-called black Hispanics and Native Americans. And down there in Texas, the Levites, so-called Haitians, they are catching hell, man. Esau is treating them like shit, man. Esau is showing you how he feels about you, man. And it's gonna be more and more, it's gonna be intensified as we're closer and closer to the day of Yahweh Hashem Shai.
Yeah, if I may add that Esau's past is now coming to light and being now made manifest now in these latter days. And you know, Esau is the so-called white man according to the Bible. You know, lately the radar has been down on our people to trust them and act like they're for us, you know, with the whole voting system giving us benefits, whether it's food stamps, etc., you know, housing, even free healthcare, so on and so forth. So, you know, with Esau's tricks and you know, it's a little bit of his gifts, he kind of took the radar off of our people to not look at him sideways and actually look at him as actual potential friend or someone you can trust. But as the scripture says in Ecclesiasticus, I guess we can get that real quick. Mm-hmm. It says to never trust thy enemies, you know, and we're starting to see that Esau's wickedness is now rusted, you know, is actually being shown, you know. And their history, they cannot escape, you know. It's starting to make them shameful, you know. Mm-hmm. So real quick, we got Ecclesiasticus 12, verse 10. Never trust thy enemy, for like as iron rusted, so is his wickedness.
Yeah, so when you go to the word never, at any time, nor ever, you know, there's no way in hell you can trust these devils, man. Never, man, because they are your enemies. Mm-hmm. You don't expect your enemies to look out for your best interests. Mm-hmm. Your enemies, these devils, they take pleasure in see all people suffering. You know, people, they fail to realize that, man. They fail to realize that Esau is not for them.
That's right.
This devil is for his own people. Matter of fact, Esau is not even good to his own people. He's treating his own people like shit. You know, they don't give a damn about you regular Edomites. They are in their own class, man. They don't give a damn about you or you regular Joe Edomites, man.
That's right.
No.
And with the what's going on in the that border in Texas, it's just gonna show that they have no love for you so-called Issacharites. I mean, so-called Mexicans, which are the Issachar, and even you so-called Haitians, which is Levi, man. You know, these Edomites think that this is their land. You know, they think that everybody else is a foreigner, or everybody is needs to go back to their own land. This is that whole spirit that Trump came in with, to make America great again. They have put that spirit in Esau to feel like they got to rise up and stay in power and put all these other nations in submission into captivity, man. And with this article, it's just going to show that they're not going to be at the best interest of you so-called Haitians, man. You know, all you so-called Latinos or so-called Negroes, man. And again, like the brother mentioned, as the scripture says, they you know, they're about to show their horns, because as according to Revelations, the 12th chapter, they have but a short time, man.
Yeah.
So we can get to this article, unless you got something else, bro.
Yeah.
This is from the NBCnews.com. Paskey asked about image of Border Patrol agent with apparent whip. Obviously horrific.
Yeah, this devil, that, hey, that's what they used to do in slavery, man. During slavery time, he saw you to whip you like a, you know, like there is no tomorrow. You know, he brings them joy. If Jake trying to escape from their former slave master, Esau will go after them, make an example out of them. If Jake is rebellious, Esau wanna bring you to shame in front of your family, pull you out, and beat you to death, man.
That's right. White House press security Jen Psaki called the images horrible, but said she could not yet address what the consequences would be. And there's an image of the Border Patrol agent seen holding apparent whip during the encounter with Haitian immigrants, man. Hey, they're gonna go to that spirit, man. Whipping, humiliating, brutalizing, tormenting you Israelites. And ultimately, it's because they have a perpetual hatred, you know, from the womb. You know, they are the they're the wicked. You're the righteous. You know, they have, they're the ops. They're complete opposite from you. The Lord created them to hate you and to show their hatred for you, man.
I got a precept to back you up.
Yep.
Ecclesiastes 10 verse 5. There is an evil which I have seen under the sun as an error which proceeded from the ruler. Folly is set in great dignity, and the rich sit in low place. I have seen servants upon horses and princes walking as upon the earth.
That's right. And right, this is the servants that are upon horses, as Esau right now in these images. They're on the horses as they're in rulership, but they're the Lord created them to be slaves upon the earth. And the princes are walking as servants. Those immigrants, the so-called Haitians, the so-called Hispanic, so-called Native Americans, the Negroes, you are the princes, but you're servitude. You're in a captivity and slave mentality, because the Lord had put these heathens over us, man. And that's a curse upon us, because we failed to keep the law, statute, commandments. So the Lord punished us, and that was a curse, you know, that we have to go to the want of all things to our enemy, you know, and they're going to beat us perpetually. They're going to have they're going to be the head, we're going to be the tail, you know. So this is what Solomon prophesying, you know, that this is a role reversal. You know, but when Yahweh Shai, who the world ignorantly calls Jesus Christ, when he comes back, he's going to set that order and put the princes that was once walking as servants to be upon horses, on rulership, on mighty, and they're going to rule forever. And this is why we're going to reward her, which is Babylon, but ultimately Esau, Edom, reward her double as she rewarded unto us, man. And that's why they're going to go through slavery, man. So we'll continue on to this article. White House Press Secretary Jen Psaki on Monday called images of a U.S. Border Patrol agent on horseback chasing Haitian immigrants horrific, but declined to say what consequences there should be for his actions. And ultimately, Esau is going to stick together. You know, they're not going to put that that Border Patrol agent on strict... consequences or you know, repercussions, you know, because ultimately these governments, these people in high places, which is Esau, Edom, they're going to look out for that brotherhood. They ultimately all have a hatred towards you Israelites, man, you know. Paskey was asked repeatedly to comment on photos of border agents on horseback using what appears to be whips on Haitian immigrants, and whether it was appropriate behavior. Hey, they did that to the Native Americans once they conquered America, you know, or the Asheref, you know, a land where no man dwelled besides the Israelites. You know, they were using the same tactics, whips, swords, weaponry, guns, to kill and to humiliate and destroy you Israelites, man.
Yeah, the Trail of Tears, Andrew Jackson, when he had the Native Americans walk all the way from the Midwest to Florida. That's they were doing that, man.
That's right.
You know, these are clear, these are prophecy to let you know who are the Lord's chosen people, man.
And best believe they were going through torture through walking that far. It wasn't no new shoes. You know, they were walking on rocks, all type of pavement, dirt, hell, you know, cuts, wounds, all type of torment and struggle and pain that the Israelites had to go through, because ultimately the servants was upon horses. They abused their power. As the scripture says, they furthered the affliction, man. You know, continuing on, I have seen some of the footage. I don't have the full context. I can't imagine what context would make the make that appropriate, but I don't have additional details, she told reporters at the Daily White House briefing. I don't think anyone seeing that footage would think it's acceptable or appropriate. Homeland Security head Alejandro Mayorkas was asked about the photo earlier in the day while visiting Del Rio, Texas, where more than 15,000 mostly Haitian immigrants have converged on a border bridge. He said the reporter who asked him about the whip was assuming the facts and suggested it was possible the agent was simply holding a long rein.
Yeah, that's Esau looking out for the own, man.
Mm-hmm.
You know, look, that's these devils. They are on code. They know, they know that they have privilege, and they're not willing to put their privilege apart and to come after the own.
That's
exactly what it is. They look after the own, man. You know.
That's right. Wiley Buffett.
Homeland, matter of fact, yeah.
To ensure control of the horse, long reins were used, but we were going to investigate the facts to ensure that the situation is as we understand it to be, and if it's anything different, we will respond accordingly, he said. Testifying before the Senate Homeland Security Committee on Tuesday, Mayorkas said he had been horrified to see the images. We do not tolerate any mistreatment or abuse of an immigrant, period, he added.
Hey, man, that's shows you the hypocrisy of these devils, man. These devils, they have been going all over the world causing chaos, mayhem, destruction, man.
Mm-hmm.
And they push the image to the world that they are failed people, or pious people, man. And that's the witchcraft that these devils, they have been using for a long time. But right now, we are at a time they can no longer hide their true intention. The Lord Yahweh Shimshai is revealing them. They can no longer hide themselves, you know?
Kind of got Zechariah 11 verse 4. Zechariah 11 verse 4. Thus said the Lord, my power, feed the flock of the slaughter, whose possessors slay them and hold themselves not guilty. And they that sell them say, blessed be the Lord, for I am rich, and their own shepherds pity them not. For I will no more pity the inhabitants of the land, said the Lord. But lo, I will deliver the men, everyone to his neighbor's hand, and into the hand of his king, and they shall smite the land, and out of their hand I will not deliver them.
Yeah, whose possessors slay them and hold themselves in that guilty. These devils, they never want to be held accountable for their action, man.
That's right.
They always trying to escape the punishment. Oh, slavery, everybody was slave at one time, you know.
Yeah, that's right.
Slavery is over. Why let's move forward. Don't go back to the past. You know, they always find excuses to escape what they have done, man. You know.
What's that? The Lord required which past?
2 Thessalonians 1:6.
Yep. Come on. I'll get that real quick. 2 Thessalonians 1:6. You said.
Mm-hmm.
Yep, 2 Thessalonians 1:6. Seeing is a righteous thing with the Most High, to recompense tribulation to them that trouble you.
Yeah, sin is a righteous thing. So it's righteous, is justice for Yahweh Shinoshai to put these devils in slavery for what they have done to us, man.
That's right.
Recompense, payback.
Payback,
man.
The big payback.
The big payback is coming. And these devils, there's no way in hell they can escape what's coming to them, man.
And to you who are troubled, rest with us when the Lord Yahweh Shai shall be revealed from heaven with his mighty angels.
And the people that's in trouble right now, it's going to be intensified in the time of Jacob's trouble. I mean, so-called Black Hispanics and Native Americans, man. These devils, like we said before, they're about to shoot a horn, man.
That's right.
The Lord Yahweh Shemeshah is about to pour onto Esau the hatred that he had during slavery times, man.
That's right.
You know?
Yep. Revelations 12, verse 12. Therefore rejoice, ye heavens, and ye that dwell in them. Woe unto the inhabitants of the earth and of the sea, for the devil is come down unto you, having great wrath, because he knoweth that he hath but a short time.
Yeah. you know, the devil come down unto you having great wrath. I mean, we're supposed to be rejoicing because we know before we can enter the kingdom, we have tribulation.
I said Acts.
Everything, the very foundation of America must turn upside down, you know, through much tribulation shall we enter the kingdom of Yahweh Hashem Shai. These devils, they know that they have a short time, and that's exactly why they have laws on the book to they declare war on the so-called black Hispanics and Native Americans. But the vast majority of our people, they fail to realize it, man. They fail to realize that they are at war, man. You know?
Where's that Acts what?
14 verse 14.
22. Yep, Acts 14 verse 22. Confirming the souls of the disciples and exhorting them to continue in the faith, and that we must through much tribulation enter into the kingdom of heaven.
Yeah, tribulation, you know, trouble. That's right. Another word for tribulation, trouble, or time like no other. You know, Jeremiah, described Jacob's trouble as a time such as never was since there was a nation. You know, because these devils, they have all kind of technology. They have Esau has increased in his technology might, you know.
Yep.
So that's exactly why we're going to need a power from above, divine intervention, a power from above to save us from the head of the devils, man.
That's right. Yeah. And then you can, you know, read about it, and also Second Ezra, like the brother mentioned, Jeremiah 30, Daniel's 12 chapter, Second Ezra 15 and 16. Hey, the Lord is going to be using these devils, mainly Esau, Edom, and their military, their FEMA officers, to cause great wrath, the great insurrection upon those that fear the Lord. They're going to show that their hatred is towards you Israelites, you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans. And they're not going to look out for your best interest, man. They're going to do what the Lord is going to give the spirit to do, man, is to get rid of you on non-desirables. The two-thirds of Israel must be cut off and die, because ultimately the Lord is calling out to you Israelites, but only the election are attaining it. Two-thirds of our people don't believe. They scoff, they scorn, they think this is a fantasy or a conspiracy. Hey, but through these articles, this is how we measure the time diligently. This is how we know that, hey, the Lord's words is not going to go without void, and it's going to become faithful and true. And two-thirds of our people must feel it by death, by pain. And this is just the again, like the beginning of sorrows, man. So with that, man, we pray everything was edifying. It was just a quick lesson. Lord willing, we'll leave this article in the description box. But it just shows that, hey, Esau has no love for you so-called Negroes, so-called Jamaicans, you so-called Haitians, so-called Latinos, so-called Native Americans, man. You guys are the children of the Most High, and the Lord hates y'all Salakia, and the Lord put the spirit in Esau to hate y'all with a perfect hatred, man. So again, we pray everything was edifying. We want to give all praises, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Bashim, Awashai, Bashim, Akak. Kadash, double honors to our apostles and elders, a great millstone who rule well and taught us this truth, and peace and salutations to the Bayafta Wadah. That's the house of David the elect. Until next time, we want to say Adawan Ratazah, which means Lord willing, Shalom.